and here is my sweet cream or sweet corn casserole. Here we go, my chicken and rice with almond. I got 14 little circles out of this. Oh my gosh, that's 2 teaspoons of cinnamon. And here we are. I didn't think it was gonna pop up that easily, but you can use a smaller bowl. That. So good and yummy. Oh my gosh. I gotta get to chopping those onions. And you know what I forgot on my plate? A piece of sausage. Putting this on top. And oh my gosh, these are delicious. Hot, delicious. Isn't that cute? And there, that's the finished one. I wish I had videotaped in there. Howdy everyone, this is Trisha and welcome again to my channel. Today is the Friday before Sunday Easter, or Easter Sunday is probably the way I should have said that. And I'm going to be making my abuelita's pan de naranja, which is her orange pound cake, my grandmother's orange pound cake, but it's not going to be orange. No va a ser naranja. It will be lemon. Lo voy a hacer de limón. So es el pastel de limón o pan de limón. All right, so this is what it's going to be. It's going to be my lemon pound cake. So I've switched up my grandmother's recipe with just a couple of ingredients. I'm going to be using the same one. I did a video on that for my 100th video. I will leave a link down below so you can check that out. It is a very similar recipe. I'm just going to change a couple of things. And let me go down through my ingredients so that you'll know what to get ready so that you can also make this lovely pound cake. First of all, we're going to need the zest of a couple of lemons. And I've got these huge lemons here. These are Valley lemons. I live in the Rio Grande Valley, and these are the lemons that you can find here. And so I got two of these because I thought I could get a nice amount of zest out of these. And I want to try and get at least 2 tablespoons of zest, okay? So get yourself as many lemons as you need to get to zest for that. And I'm going to need 4 sticks of unsalted butter. We want unsalted butter because we're going to add a little bit of salt, and we want to make sure this is not too salty. And it's a little bit healthier that way too. So I've got 4 sticks. That's 1 pound of unsalted butter, real butter. Okay, we're also going to need 3 eggs, and it's going to be large eggs. So I've got 3 eggs here. We're going to need 2 teaspoons of vanilla, but here's where I'm going to change it. I'm going to put 1 teaspoon of vanilla, and I'm going to put 1 teaspoon of almond extract. So these are the 2 things that I'm going to use, 1 teaspoon of vanilla and 1 teaspoon of almond extract. Almond goes really well with lemon, so that's what I'm going to use. 2 cups of sugar, and you just need just plain white sugar. You're going to need 4 cups of all-purpose flour. You're also going to need 6 teaspoons of baking powder, and I've just got some regular baking powder. Just use your favorite brand. 1 teaspoon of salt. Here we go. And we're also going to need 1 cup of some warm milk. So I need to warm this up. Now, I also need to mention that your butter does need to be at room. It needs to be soft in the room. So leave it out, you know, to 2 hours or so before you use it to get it to get softened. You could speed it up a little bit by putting it in the microwave, maybe 30 seconds, you know, at a time, just to make sure it doesn't completely melt. You don't want it hot. You want it room temperature. You just want it soft. And also your eggs, go ahead and take them out and let them also get to room temperature. It's always nice if you could use room temperature eggs. Okay, so we're going to go ahead and get started. All right, so I've already grated the 2 lemons that I had here. I just use this little miniature garlic grater that I have, and I've used that to scrape the skin of my lemon so that I could zest it. And I've got about, I would say about 1.5 tablespoons in there. I really wanted 2 tablespoons, but this will work. And if I have to, I'll add a little squeeze of the lemon juice just to give it a little bit extra punch to the flavor of my cake. So I've got my butter in here. That's, again, that was 4 sticks of butter, so it's 1 pound. And I'm gonna go ahead and add all that lemon zest to that. There we go. We're gonna go ahead and get that mixing. All nice and pretty. All right, the next thing we're gonna add is 3 eggs. So just 3 whole eggs to that. 1, 2, and 3. Now you can crack these on a separate little bowl and then pour them in. It doesn't matter how you want to do that. Just get 3 eggs in there. All right, my third ingredient would be the vanilla, but like I said, I'm going to do half vanilla, half almond. And I'm kind of tempted to do just half a teaspoon of the vanilla and then 1 1/2 of the almond. So that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to add half a teaspoon of vanilla. And well, my measuring is basically whatever falls in. That's my measurement. So now 1 1/2 of almond. So that's 3 of these halves. There we go. Let's take a whiff. Oh my God, that smells so good. Okay. And then of course, the fifth ingredient that I want to mix in there is my 2 cups of sugar. So I'm just going to add in 2 cups. A little bit of butter that's splattered out. Get that in there. That looks so good. So I can push down on the sides and make sure everything got in there. I'm going to give it a little bit of a taste. Just a tiny bit. I'm going to make sure I can taste the lemon. And I can, and I can taste a lot of that almond. So I'm going to add a little squirt of lemon juice. So let's cut the lemon. Go just a squirt, a little more. There we go. Squirt of lemon juice in there. Yes, that's good. It smells so good. Alright, so now we're gonna be adding flour to this. We're gonna make sure this is all mixed up really nice, and it is. I'm gonna turn that off so that you can see that. Get that in there. Look at that. That's what you want your butter and your sugar to look like. These top, the first 5 ingredients that will be mentioned on the recipe. All right, now we're gonna add some flour. We need 4 cups of flour, and we wanna add those in very slowly because we're gonna end up with flour everywhere. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna add a cup at a time, mix it in a little bit, and put down the mixer onto it because I don't want flour to go flying, although it'll still happen. So I'm gonna fill up 2 cups first. There we go. That's 2 cups right there. That's about a cup right there. I'm just going to push it in, blend it a bit with my spatula. Okay, and now we can go ahead and push this down. And hopefully that'll keep it from having flour flying everywhere. All right, so I'm gonna go ahead and continue by adding the other cup and then the 2 more cups of flour. That'll be 4 cups altogether. And then I will be adding the 6 tablespoons of baking powder and 1 teaspoon of salt, and then at last my milk. So I will be back and do the rest of that for you. One thing I forgot to mention is to sift your flour. That's something that I missed doing with the first 2 cups. That's okay if you don't have to, but you really, you know, you want it to be a nice light mixture. No crumbs are in there from the flour. Make it all nice and light. Then go ahead and sift it, which is what I'm doing right now with the other 2 cups. This is just to break down the flour. And I'm going to go ahead and add the teaspoons of baking powder to this. And I need 6. Again, this recipe will be repeated in the description below, so if you didn't catch the amounts, they will be in the description box below, as always. This is half a teaspoon, that's 1 teaspoon of salt.
And mix it up, and I'll be done.
All right. right? So I've already incorporated all the flour into my batter. Now I've got to add the milk. And again, when I do pour in the milk, it does the whole same thing where everything goes splattering around. So let me mix in a little bit of that in there. A little lemon seed there. Gotta watch out for those. Okay, so if you don't want to zest a lemon, you feel like that's a little bit too much work, you don't feel confident about it, you can use some lemon extract, and you probably want to use maybe a couple of teaspoons of that, and then you can just taste your batter, and if you feel like you need a little bit extra, you can add in, but I wouldn't add 2 tablespoons like I did of the extract, I mean of the zest of the lemon. Just a couple of teaspoons, just like you would add vanilla. So maybe instead of the almond and vanilla, just the lemon extract, or you can combine the lemon and the almond. It all depends on how strong a taste lemon extract has. I've not used it, so I don't know how potent it is. So you'd want to go a little bit at a time on that. Okay, I feel like I've added the milk in there enough where it won't go splattering all over on me. So let's see. There we go. Well, a little bit, but that's okay. In there. I've got a little bit more, a little bit at a time. See, still some splattering. Right, like I said, all the amounts will be repeated in the description box below. All right, what I've also done, and I just want to make sure the milk gets mixed in there really well, and makes a really nice batter, and I'll show you that in a moment, how it looks, so you can get a closer look at it. In the meantime, I went ahead and I floured 2 loaf pans. What I did is I used some shortening. You can use some butter, or you can use that spray stuff if you want. But I used some shortening with a napkin, and I rubbed it at the bottom and all over the sides. Threw in some flour, shook it up really well till it was all coated, and just shook off the excess. So I've got 2 pans here ready. I'm going to fill up this bigger one first, and then the smaller one. And this looks really nice. So I'm going to go ahead and show you. It's really creamy batter. Oops, went the wrong way. Make sure none of this goes. Okay. Put that off of here. And there you go. That is what the batter should look like for your pound cake. Again, this is a lemon pound cake. And I've already tasted the batter, and I really like the way it tasted. I like the flavor. It doesn't have a very strong lemon taste, so like I said, if you want to go ahead and go for more of the zest, I can get 2 tablespoons, which I didn't get that much out of these two, so I probably need a third one to make sure I do so. Make sure you get yourself a good amount of lemons if you want to zest them. Otherwise, get yourself some lemon extract and then just flavor it that way. I'm sure it'll be just as good. Tasting it one more time. Okay, I'm ready to go ahead and put them into my pans. I've got my oven preheated at 350 degrees, and we're gonna get them in there. They're gonna take anywhere from 45 minutes to 50 minutes, maybe even an hour to bake, okay? So this all depends on your pans, it all depends on your oven, where you're at. Now you can use a bundt cake pan if you want. That'll make a really pretty cake, and you can just make a little glaze to glaze over it. But I'm gonna go into 2 loaf pans. And, okay, so I'll be back in a minute. All right, time to fill our loaf pans. And I want to fill these up about 2/3 of the way up. And I'm going to fill up my larger one first to make sure that I do get enough in there. And then I'll do the smaller one. And I'm just going to spread it out with my spatula. What you can do is also shake. It's about a little bit more to go. There we go. That and that. I want to get a nice little rise out of it. The last time I made my abuelita's pan de naranja, or my grandmother's orange pound cake, they got a really nice little rounded top, and they will always get a little crack. You want that little crack to form in the top. That's the like a signature look of a pound cake. They got a really nice little rise to them, and a little curve at the top. But when I was doing the video, I pulled them out, had them out for a little while. They weren't quite done. I was just checking them, and I ended up videotaping that section where you could see how beautiful it was. But then when I put it back in and took them out again, I lost the rise, you know, of my curve on the top. So just when you're gonna check it, open it up real quick, have your toothpick ready to insert in there and test it to make sure it's all done. Don't leave it out for too long. Quickly put it back in if you have to. You know, 45 minutes, like I said, maybe 50 minutes, up to 1 hour for a pound cake to bake. So that is what it will take. So don't be surprised if you take an hour to bake your pound cake. Okay, I'm gonna fill in my smaller one here. Beautiful. I love how this batter turns out. It's so pretty. Can get a little bit more into this one. Okay, so just remember, if you get that crack on the top, that is perfect for a pound cake. So don't get all alarmed like, oh no, there's a big old crack on the top of my cake. What did I do wrong? Nothing. It's perfect. Here we go. These are all at least 2/3 full. I'm going to put them in the oven for 45 minutes. Actually, I'm going to put them in there for 50 minutes because the last time that I did it, it took an hour. And I don't want it any lesser time than that probably. So I'm going to put them in there for 50 minutes. Put the timer on. I'll check them real quick at 50 minutes. If they need a little more time, I'll go ahead and put them in for another 10 and they'll be done. And then I'll show you when I'm done, and I'll give you the ultimate time that I used. Again, your time might be different. I'm just giving you a more or less. And I'm gonna stick it in the oven, and I'll be back. Quick tip, while my cakes are baking, there was two things that I was gonna tell you. Well, first of all, you might ask what rack in the oven. Just put it in your middle rack, center them both in the middle rack. Little tip here for cleaning up your countertop, especially tile tops where everything gets into the grout and you're there scrubbing at it. Use those lemons that you squeezed. These are awesome because they will pull out the flour out from the grout. And of course it'll leave a nice lemony scent. So I'm just rubbing it all over my countertop because some of that flour has kind of made its way into the cracks. And I have to scrub a little too hard. And then all you gotta do is go over it with a nice clean wet sponge and wipe it off. And then if you want, wipe it again and use a dry paper towel to get it all dry. So here's a little cleaning tip right here. Right here. What did you think you were gonna get? You were gonna get a whole bunch of ideas. Yes. All right, it's been an hour later and my 2 pound cakes are out of the oven. One got done just maybe about 5 minutes before the other one because it's a little bit smaller. So that took about 55 minutes or so. And there you go. I've already pressed punched a toothpick into them and they are completely done. And you can see there's little cracks in the top. It has a little bit of a dome there, really pretty. Here's the bigger one. Just as lovely with that beautiful crack right down the middle. And they are both hot because they are fresh out of the oven. And I can smell that almond lemon taste. So I'm going to call this an almond lemon. What do you think? Should I change it? Maybe I should. I'm going to be calling it a lemon pound cake for now because some of you might decide to use lemon extract instead of the almond extract. And then you also may decide to use a little bit more zest than what I used in case you decide to just go with the extract situation. Anyway, these are my cakes. I'm going to let them cool off and then I'm going to get them out of the pans so that we can see how beautiful they look, and we're gonna slice into them and have a little taste. All right, I'm back and my cakes are now somewhat cooled off. I'm gonna go ahead and cut into this larger loaf. Look at that. Look how pretty that looks. It is so pretty. I'm gonna go ahead and cut into that one using a serrated knife. Look at how pretty that is. Let me show you up close, the texture in there. It's so pretty. Let's cut another pretty slice. Let it cool completely so you can go ahead and cut these up nicely. I had a little server here to serve the slice ready, but I ended up using my hand. And oh my goodness, take another good look at that. It is so pretty. Now it's time to taste it. All right, get a nice piece there, like the little edge on that. It looks so pretty. Mm-hmm. That's all I can say. My mouth is full. It's delicious. Excuse me. Did you enjoy this recipe? Or you'd like to try it? Let me know what you thought of it. And if you have your own recipe or you'd like me to check out a video, go ahead and link it down below and share your recipe for your pound cake. I hope you enjoyed it again. Please subscribe. Give me a big old thumbs up. And as always, enjoy.